Aloha and welcome. And April 27th, 2024, in this here and now reality. I don't know when you're watching, but you're here right now. I'm sure of it. Morphogenic field of evolution that we are creating. So thank you for bringing your attention here. And Kaimi's going to remind me in a few minutes to do intention as well. She and I are going to take you on a journey for about an hour with these magnificent instruments and these magnificent instruments and these magnificent instruments. The invitation is to find a place where you can be comfortable and not have to move too much in the next hour. If you've got good speakers, that's awesome. If you've got computer speakers, find headphones. You'll have a better journey. If you're in the digital world, a lot of energy happens when these get going. So sometimes, especially for new people who haven't experienced a lot of this before, you've got these energy meridians up and down and through your body. If the sound waves coming through run into blockages that you have for whatever reason, it can get a little twitchy sometimes. I don't think I've ever heard of somebody being in pain over it, but people with knee issues, sometimes they'll feel a little bit more pressure there, maybe a little increase in pain if they've been in a delicate situation recently. Not to worry. Find your breath, follow your breath, push your breath down through those energy channels and help relieve that blockages that are there. And then when that energy block gets released, let it go, give it to Gaia. Kaimi and I will share three breaths before we get started, and in that process we ground out and grow roots in the Mama Gaia. I encourage you to do the same. That gives energy channels for anything that you're finished with to be taken up by Mama, transmuted, and sent back to you for whatever she decides. It also builds those energy channels for her gifts to come up. So it's a good thing to do. That's story I've got. I'm sticking to it. Loud and soft, loud and soft. Sometimes it gets very quiet. Until I call you back, try to stay in your space. Or you may stay in your space. I will call you back when we're finished playing. So if it gets quiet for a few minutes and you're wondering what the heck's going on, it's just because we're given silence a time to have its say. And the invitation is to just be with your body and see what it might have to tell you. Or be with your brain and subconscious and creative creation and let anything come up that needs to come up. Okay, enough talk. Water would be good. We'll talk a little bit more about that at the end. Are you ready? Intention. A lot of energy can be produced in this. Sound waves hitting your interstitial, the fluid in your interstitial tissues releases electricity. There's energy transfer that happens. I make up that if you carry an intention into the journey with you, you can use that energy to help actuate, to activate, actualize those intentions. That intention could be just like to have a nap. I do that a lot. Shall we do this? My honey went to a birthday party of a friend of ours who made her very, very fairy goddess lei, haku lei for her. And so now she looks just beautiful. All right, an hour-ish. Thank you.
Thank you. Thank you.
as this sound journey draws to a close. The invitation is to find your breath. No need to change it, just notice where it is. And allow that noticing to gently guide you back home. Perhaps allowing your mind to sweep through your body. Take stock of what you feel, where you feel. No wrong answers. Grab hold of the pearls of wisdom that may have been gleaned on your journey. Whispers from the angels. Screams from the void. As your awareness flows through more and more of your body, you may find that there are parts of you that would like to move now, please. I encourage you to resist as long as possible. For those in the digital world, smash that like button, eh? Drink plenty of water for the next few days. It'll help flush anything that got released that no longer is necessary on your journey this time around. If you're going to drive anytime soon, get your feet on the ground. Breathe for a few minutes. There's still a lot going on. Including my kitty making herself comfortable on victory. Get hugs. Get lost in lots of hugs. My queen told me that the 20 seconds of hugging is equivalent to about 6 seconds of kissing. So, you know, if you want to speed the process up, triple your fun, same amount of time. I don't know if that's true, but I sure felt good when we were done. Woo, doggy! Y'all have a pleasant day, evening, morning, whatever. And, see you again. You'll see us again. Maybe we found a way to look through that and see how.
They're so small!
Bless me. Come on!